That is my second wedding look. Actually, my third, because I had two wedding looks on my first wedding. But that was my first wedding look on my second wedding. Hi, I'm Lily Allen, and this is my fashion flashback. Do I remember that look? I mean, I have seen pictures of it. Do I remember being in that look? Probably not. It was at a festival. Best of all, 2007, I think. A lot of fun was had. It was really like in the early days of my musical career. So, you know, it was a lot of fun. It was hopeful and innocent, you know? It was innocent. I think I look good there. I like that look. How do I feel about making dress and trainers a trend? I don't think I did, really. I think I'm credited with it, but I don't think I personally can take credit for it. I don't feel like I invented that look, but maybe it, you know, became bigger after I, you know, smashed it to pieces. Oof, would I wear it again? I don't think I would wear it again. There was a sort of reason behind it. I wasn't very, you know, confident in my body shape at the time. It was sort of before, you know, women with larger figures were appreciated so much in the mainstream. And so I was very self-conscious about my legs. And so I would wear prom dresses to sort of like accentuate my waist, but cover up my legs. So it's a bit sad, really. But yeah, that's the story behind it. That is me wearing a leather jumpsuit by Hermes at Paris Fashion Week 2023. Yeah, I think it's pretty cool. I'm liking my hair, this new shade of orange, and you know, with a classic Birkin, which was my birthday present actually from my lovely husband. So thank you, David Harbour. Quiet luxury is like a term, that terminology that's been sort of coined of late. I think it's sort of, you know, brands like The Row are quiet luxury, Hermes. Yeah, that's the only two I can think of off the top of my mind. Would I wear it again? Yes, I'd absolutely wear it again. That is me playing Glastonbury on the Pyramid Stage in 2009. I believe that jumpsuit is a brand called Issa. And my wig is by a hairdresser called Tyler, and I'm wearing Solange little pixie ears. I do seem to wear quite a lot of jumpsuits on stage. I like jumpsuits generally. I think they're fun, easy. You know, I was wearing a lot more sort of garish stuff in my, you know, late teens and 20s, and I've kind of got a little bit quieter and more restrained in my 30s and late 30s. I would not wear that look again. I don't think that is timeless. I don't even know if it was on trend at the time. It was a little bit wacky even then, and I don't think I would wear it now. I don't not like it. I just don't think I would wear it again. That is my second wedding look. Actually, my third, because I had two wedding looks on my first wedding. But that was my first wedding look on my second wedding. Yeah, it's major, this look. I think it's really, really good. I absolutely love the dress. It was Christian Dior off the rack at the Bellagio Hotel from the Christian Dior boutique. I had a whole other look planned. I was going to wear like this massive sort of Dolly Parton-esque number, which I'd rented from a bridal rental store in Las Vegas. But my daughter didn't like it. She said, come on, let's go out one more time and just have a look. And then I tried that on and she went, I don't think we're leaving here without this. And so, yeah, she decided. It just looks great. It's like a timeless, classic, great wedding dress. I just think it's, you know, I think it's one of my fashion high points. Many. I would wear it again. Maybe at my next wedding. No jokes. I do remember the look. I can't remember who the designer is. I know it was a vintage dress that I got from a vintage dealer friend of mine called William Vintage. The bag is Chanel, and I matched my hair to my bag, which I think is quite legendary. Would I ever do that again? No, I think it was definitely sort of the time. I don't think I'm as committed to my fashion choices these days as I was then. So no, I wouldn't. But I'm glad I did. Is there any trend I regret trying? Yes, actually, there was. And I think in the like sort of late noughties, in the 2009, 2010 era, I used to just shove a load of like glitter like under my eyes, but I always get photographed by the paparazzi quite a lot. So I just sort of looked like a mad panda because the, you know, the light would just reflect off of the glitter. It didn't look sort of fabulous. It looked a bit bonkers. So yeah, I probably wouldn't do that again. I do remember that look. I mean, I think the outfit is pretty fabulous, but I think I look absolutely haggard in that picture. I don't know why I look so old. I don't think I was particularly happy at this period of my life. But I do think that the jacket is quite fabulous and the bag. And yes, I would say it's timeless. It's, you know, Chanel tweed coat. Can't really go wrong. That look was only a couple of months ago, and it was me leaving the Duke of York's Theatre. I did a play called The Pillow Man there, and it's a dress by Magda Butrim, I think is how you pronounce her name. I think it's pretty cool, this look. I'm into it. Yeah, I think I'd wear that look again. I think it's pretty timeless. Yeah, it's a great silhouette. It's a really good shape, and you know, I like it all. The play that I was doing was really harrowing. And I was here in London on my own. My husband was in New York and my kids were not here. They were at summer camp. So I was coming off stage and feeling quite sort of isolated and lonely and deflated. I dressed up once or twice and found that it really helped sort of lift my mood with leaving the theatre and coming out of, you know, being on stage and being in one character and then getting changed into someone slightly more glamorous and less intense. So yeah, it just became sort of a routine. It was fun. And also, you know, there was always like a quite a big crowd of people waiting outside to have their photo taken with me every night and have things signed and autographs and all of that sort of stuff. And so it became quite nice for everybody involved. You know, I felt good. They got pictures of me looking my best. And, you know, and the paparazzi were taking pictures every night and we got good publicity and sold more tickets. So everyone was a winner. Thank you for watching. That was my fashion flashback.